All right, Chantel, I love this next topic. It might be one of my favorites out of the 10. We went back and forth a lot about this one. I think you actually brought it up. It's so important. And you talked a little bit about providing that network of support, specifically in that mental health space. I'd love to hear more about why that's important and what that means in terms of inclusive leadership.
Oh, absolutely. This is actually one of my favorite topics to talk about and building human connection, right?
So
the second hack that we really talked about was providing a network of support. And community is so important in building those supportive, inclusive environments. I found it really interesting that even though we're in this crazy digital transformation of life, and we have more social media and connectivity than ever before, Generation Z is deemed the loneliest generation yet, which is so sad because it feels like even though we're connecting, we're not. We're actually separating ourselves, which is terrible for building inclusive environments.
Yeah.
So creating a warm environment where people feel connected and where people can feel really comfortable and safe, opening their minds up and their opinions up and sharing that creativity brings innovation. So there's three hacks or three tips for this hack that I thought of, which is first and foremost, the most important soft skill ever, practice active listening. Be an amazing listener. Don't interrupt, right? Lean in and listen when somebody doesn't seem to be sharing much because there's obviously some hesitation there, and figuring out that feedback, getting that feedback and figuring out why they're not feeling that that's a safe environment can help you build further into that inclusion, right? Also, team building, making sure that these groups are connected and feel like they can rely on each other and share some vulnerabilities, because if we can't talk about our weaknesses, we can't grow and get stronger. And then anecdotes. These are my favorite because it's so small and silly, but it can bring people together so much better, right? Just knowing little tiny things about a person that you can bring up as an inside joke helps release pressure. It relieves stress and brings people together with laughter. And laughter's the best medicine, let's be honest, right? What about you? What are your...
I love this. And it's so interesting that you say that about Gen Z, because I noticed it too. It's almost this surface level relationship that we're having, because you're texting back and forth, or how's your day? I'm okay. You know, we're not getting to the meat of it. And especially in companies, if you're working virtually and you're on a phone call, or if you don't see people, they can't know you're laughing or smiling. You know, I guess they can know if you're laughing, if you can hear. But the verbal, nonverbal cues, I think, are so important too, of, oh, that's a really cool watch, I like your earrings, or what's going on. Like, you can actually see where people are and how they're living their life. And I think, like, that's so important when you're trying to create those spaces, because people come and go for managers, people come and go for teams. It's about feeling that community that you're talking about, feeling that connection to people. Because you can love the cause, but if you don't like the people that you're working with, you're probably going to head out.
Yes, absolutely.
It's hacking.
I know. That's a big piece of the environment, is the people you're working with and the team you're on. And if it doesn't feel like family, you're going to spend more time with them than your own family. So,
yeah.
Right? They better feel like family.
Exactly. I also wanted to bring up, I don't know if any companies you've worked for, I think they're really interesting, and they're underutilized services, or those EAP programs, the employee resource programs that are offered. So in terms of thinking about being inclusive and building that community, doing an action step of figuring out what are the programs that are offered within your organization. Because oftentimes we might have gotten an email or something, we might have gotten lost. But to ask human resources, ask your supervisor, there are a lot of free resources that are available. We actually talk to someone within your organization or outside for that unbiased opinion. That's free. If you're having a bad day, if you have some mental health issues that you want to work through, or they can refer you to someone else. And I think they're just so underutilized.